Kaibigan, magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. So kung bago ka pa lang sa aking channel, ako po yung inyong lingkod para tutorial video. So yung ating pag-uusapan ngayon is tungkol po sa tinatawag na police blotter. Ano ba ito? So when we talk about PNP Police Operational Procedure, yung pinaka number one rule is police blotter. So kung gusto niyo magkaroon ng kaalaman regarding po sa ating topic ngayon, just relax, lend me your ears, and stay tuned to my channel para tutorial videos. Now, as a general rule, each PNP operating units shall maintain a police blotter where all types of operational and undercover dispatches shall be recorded. Yun po yung general rule. Kaya nga, pag pumunta tayo sa isang police station, yung pinaka-window ng police station or territorial units is the DO or the desk officer. Siya yung may hawak ng police blotter book. So ano yung police blotter book? Ito yung blue color, malaking official logbook with hardbound cover. Lahat ng mga daily registered crime incident and summary of arrest as well as yung mga significant incident occurring in territorial jurisdiction of territorial units or police station dapat nakasulat dyan sa police blotter book. Now, ano yung importance ng police blotter? So, it serves as a permanent record of events or incident or problems and so forth. So, marami pong mga reports sa police blotter and all of which ay may kanya-kanyang differences or functions. So, sometimes yung police blotter ay magagamit natin to inform peoples of the activities within the police jurisdiction. And also magagamit natin to confile statistical information. And also, we use police blotter to identify issues and concern and also to identify problems within the community. Now, my question is this. Kapag kayong isang tao is involved po or subject of the police blotter dahil mayroong complainant against sa kanya regarding sa isang violation of crimes or criminal incident, siya po yung pinaka-suspect sa kaso. Yung tanong dyan, is that particular person or suspect has a criminal record the moment na ipinablatter siya sa police station? Yung sagot dyan is, wala siyang criminal record. Dahil yung police blotter, klaruhin po natin, is not a complaint or pagsampa ng kaso. It is a record. Ito yung pag-record ng mga incident or criminal incident sa isang police station or territorial units. So, hindi ito complaints or pagsampa ng kaso. Ito po ay magagamit natin to facilitate investigation or to prepare court cases. So in other words, yung police blotter can be used as evidence in filing cases. Guys, tandaan po natin, base po sa ating saligang batas, magkakaroon lamang ng criminal record isang individual kapag mayroong kasong isinampa or pending cases sa anumang hukuman dito sa Pilipinas. Now guys, punta tayo sa mga legal bases ng police blotter. Unang-una, yung mga incident involving crime incident, dapat lahat yan nakarecord sa official blotter book. So if the incident is crime incident verified by the desk officer, he or she shall accomplish the IRF or incident record form using the CERAS or Crime Incident Reporting and Analysis System, in which yung blotter entry ng nasabing reports or records is pwedeng ma-extract. If yung mga incident is under the jurisdiction of katarungang pambarangay, so pwede bang ma-record sa police blotter? Pwede. As long as yung disposition of cases naka-indicate dapat sa police blotter that particular cases is referable to barangay. How about yung mga incidents involving sa ICL or child in conflict with the law? So hindi yan nakalagay sa official blotter book. Mayroong separate blotter book yung women's desk officer na color pink, no? Kasi yung CICL is a minor. So may separate handling of cases as well as recording system yung women's desk officer for the purpose of confidentiality. Now, we will proceed to the procedures of making entries of the police blotter. So kailangan yung handwritten is clear, concise, and simple manner and should be answerable by 5 W's and 1 H or cardinal principle or cardinal elements. So ano-ano itong mga 5 W's and 1 H? Ito yung who was involved, when did it happen, where did it take place, what happened, why did it happen, and how did it happen. Kapag yung 5 W's and 1 H, no, are present during the reports of the police blotters, meaning yung reports or content ng police blotter is complete. And also, part of the procedures in making entry of the police blotter ay kailangan facts, not opinion, yung police blotter. At saka yung bullpen na ginagamit is either blue or black ink color. At kailangan walang erasures if necessary. At kung mayroon man o nagkamali yung desk officers, he will draw a one horizontal line to such word or process kung saan siya nagkamali at lagyan niya sa itaas ng kanyang initial signature. At tandaan natin ito, guys. Any misrepresentation or any attempts to suppress the information ay may kaukulang criminal and administrative liability. And finally, as soon as the incident is transcribed in the police blotter, the desk officer and the reporting person shall indicate their names and signature. So guys, I hope na may natutunan kayo sa ating content ngayong araw. At kung nandito pa kayo sa aking channel, paki-like, share, subscribe, and hit na rin ang bell icon so that magiging updated po kayo sa akin pang gagawing mga videos. Maraming pong salamat, and ito po yung inyong lingkod para tutorial videos.